another episode of Versus. We've got Kev Walsh with me again. It's Hello. Almost like they're putting a mouthy guy on to fight the fight.
Kev, fight the fight for Liverpool.
To fight the fight for Liverpool. But today Kev's fighting the fight for Istanbul. Dan's fighting the fight for Madrid. And which one's better? The impossible job against maybe a side's destiny, some would say. You're having that one, Kev? Do you like that?
That's a lovely little synopsis of it. Lovely.
I'm pleased, okay. Maybe I win this battle after all. Okay, yeah, so what we're going to do, we're going to go to Kev, we're going to go to Dan. They're going to give their account of why they believe Madrid's better, why Istanbul's better. Kev, the impossible job, Madrid 3-0 down, everyone knows the story. Why is it better than Madrid, mate?
Even before that, let's go back to the group stage, which tough group stage, but we got through no problems. Sort of in the end. That night when Gerrard scored that goal against Olympiacos could have been up there with Anfield's greatest ever night on its own. Unbelievable. We were out, we were done, and then Gerrard steps up and does what he does to get us through. We followed that up with a game against Bayer Leverkusen, and it's not the Bayer Leverkusen of today, you're talking probably maybe a Dortmund level team at the time, and we absolutely dismantled them at Anfield. And it was the first time I can remember at Anfield seeing us take a team that were probably our equals, if not better than us, and absolutely kill them. We were 3-0 up, and we could have been 5 up. And obviously, the goal of Scott Carson concedes a little bit of a cock-up. But then we go over there, and we do the 3-1 to them again. Unbelievable. And it was from a team that wasn't necessarily, you wouldn't have expected to be able to do stuff like that. We then go on to play Juventus, with all the things that surrounded that. Again, 2-0 up in that game, and we were absolutely brilliant. We've done the Chelsea the way we've done it. And all of these games, every one of them felt like an individual performance that was just totally out of character for the team that we had at the time. But it wasn't, because we created the season full of them. So you get to the final, and then the final comes up against probably one of the greatest European sides. It's forgotten now how good that mid-2000s AC Milan team is. But you often see the graphic put up on Twitter with their team, the players that they've got. Absolutely unbelievable. We had no right to beat them, and then to be 3-0 down and create a miracle. What more could you ask for?
And Dan, Madrid holds a very special place in your heart. It's something I know you were so desperate for, but why does that eclipse Istanbul for you?
In a few different ways, I think. Firstly, it's one that I've actually lived with my mates my age, so I know that Istanbul would have been your first big one of them. And yeah. There was like Alaves in Dortmund and stuff before with the UEFA Cup, even though it was held in higher regards. Back then, isn't quite the same as the Champions League, is it? And yeah, you know, the players and the manager that did that in 2005 will be my heroes forever, and that will never change. But being able to actually go, experience it, live through from start to finish, it was such a privilege, and that's why for me, I will have to say that I enjoyed it more. And also, if we're talking about the journey and stuff as well, rather than just the final itself, I felt like we were going to win it from the first game that we played this time, whereas Istanbul at no stage really did we have any right to win that competition, even when it goes to penalties. And you look at the list of penalty takers who were taken for Milan and who were taken for Liverpool, Milan's are better. Yeah. Milan's are better footballers, comfortably. So it's still a shock when I think you watch that game back and go, we actually won that. And we did all these games that Kev's just listed, and we actually were technically the best team in Europe, even if no one would have ever believed you. Even Benitez wouldn't have told you that we were the best team in Europe. Probably not even in the top 10, frankly, at the time. And it was a monumental achievement, therefore, to go and do it. But from when we beat Paris Saint-Germain with that late goal from Firmino this time around, I thought, we mean business here and we're going to have another series go at this again. It was a progression from the season before, getting to the final in Kiev against Real Madrid. And I thought we were unlucky in that one, in the sense that we started really brightly in it. I was doing the whole thing beforehand of, I reckon if I was doing a combined 11, I might have nearly as many Liverpool players as Real Madrid want here at this stage. But then, you know, once Salah goes off, I think we let our heads drop and they do end up deserving it. But it wasn't the end. Whereas Istanbul at the time didn't lead on to bigger and better things, because it was unrealistic that it could have, because it had all happened so quickly and so unexpectedly. Whereas we all came away from Kiev and thought, we'll be back here soon. Probably not next year, maybe not even in the next 2-3 years, but we'll be back here soon because we've got a really good team and a great manager, and we've proven that we can compete at this level. And then we played that Paris Saint-Germain game and Firmino scores the late goal, and it being a big atmosphere for it, it was good, I think, that we were playing the top seed at home first before we played any other games. And to have let them back into the game to have let them equalise, having totally dominated them for about 40 minutes, and then they probably played a bit better for the rest of the game, I think. But to then take it away from them made me think we're really good. And we're taking a team here who has been built by a state over many years now to win this competition, and we're taking it away from them like that. We're going to be real contenders for this again. And then over the course of the competition, we've played a collection of top-tier sides. Even Napoli, you know, we get that through that game in the end by this kind of our teeth with the save at the end. But they've got a manager who's won 3 European Cups, who really knows what he's doing, and has played against Liverpool a lot as well, and some really talented players. And we were too much for them. And then we did to Bayern what we did, and then Porto, we made it look a piece of piss, even though they had a really, really good football team. Semis again, you know, went away and had the poor result in Barcelona and brought them back to Anfield and made them look like they were non-league, because that's how good we were. And then in the final, we were all worried about it in the ground and it felt quite tense, but I've actually watched it back, and basically Liverpool are always winning that game of footy from when they take the lead. There's no question about it. And obviously that's less dramatic, it's less memorable to look back on than what Istanbul is, but it's a sign to me that Liverpool are genuinely the best team in Europe. And everyone knows it. All the teams that we played, all the managers that have watched us and thought, fucking hell, I've got to deal with that next season if I want to win this competition. I think back then, you know, we get knocked out by Benfica next season, don't we, in 05, 06. I don't think anyone's really thinking, I don't want to play Liverpool next year. Maybe for the atmosphere thing, maybe for the fact that, you know, it's Liverpool, it's the European Cup, and it's clearly something special. But now, we're the most feared team in world football. And that's really special, because in 05, we knew that it was brilliant and we had this story, and you know, that individual match is the best game of footy ever played, probably, and it's the most well-known game of footy ever played. But now, everyone is aware of what Liverpool are, and every footballer on the planet wants to come and play for Liverpool as well, because you had that parade afterwards where they're all having the time of their lives, nearly a million people come to the city and revel in it. The difference again this time is that they're all on that bus going, we could well be doing this again in a year. I fully believe that Liverpool are going to be in the Atatürk again in Istanbul next year, and maybe we're having an argument over that Istanbul from next year and this Madrid or something like that. But I think for me, the fact that it proves to everyone how good we are, the fact that I was able to live it, and the fact that it feels like the beginning of even more things is what tips it in Madrid's favour.
I think there's no debate that the team that we've got now smash yours.
all day, no doubt. But I'd have a go against my team.
The day and the game, do you win?
Without a shadow of a doubt. Dan, you pretty much admitted it yourself there. The final, although in the ground, I was like you, felt dead dramatic. Second half, I had to take myself for a little walk. The start of the second half, couldn't even watch it. By the time I went back down to my seat, I felt relaxed almost. Not relaxed in your normal way, but as much as you can be in a European Cup final. That day in Istanbul was absolutely unbelievable. Don't forget, we haven't been in a European Cup final for 20 years exactly. It was actually, sorry, yeah, after Heysel. We went over there, and Taksim Square the night before was the first time. It seems like a common occurrence now, because we always do it, where you have just thousands upon thousands of Liverpool supporters congregated in one space. And it'll never get old. I'll go till the day I die, I'll be going to that place where Liverpool fans congregate on match days, because it's a special feeling. It feels a bit like it started in Taksim Square the night before. Taksim Square is humongous, and it was filled from bottom to top, side to side, with Liverpool. There was red as far as the eye could see, and it was the first time I'd ever really experienced that. I'd been in the squares in Barcelona, I'd been to the same type of thing in Germany, Italy, all over the world, basically. But Taksim Square felt different. It felt like, oh my God, we're in a European Cup final. Whereas you talk about Madrid having an expectation to win it, there was no expectation at the start of that season we were going to get to a European Cup final. So we'd gone from there to there. Whereas this season we've gone from there to there, which is still enormous, but that one is, it's from the sublime, the ridiculous to the sublime. You go into the ground, the journey from Taksim Square to the Atatürk was a joke. Honestly, the stories that people tell just of the taxi ride from one place to the ground would fill a book that'd do most of the club's histories out the water. Then we have to get out the taxi and walk to the rest of the stadium. The difference, another, was it a benefit, was it a bad thing for the Atatürk? It was because it was the other side of the world and it was 2005. There was none of this, oh my God, everyone who's here is having a great time, I don't care if I get to go to the match. Everyone who went was there, and everyone who went got in the ground. So you go in the ground, and it was, I think it was 60,000, 70,000 seats in stadium. There's probably 18,000 Milan, the rest was Liverpool. There was the Fed, Madrid felt like there was a big batch of neutrals. You see it when the celebrations go up. There's no batch of neutrals in the Atatürk. There's two thirds of the ground, three quarters of the ground, which go insane when we score, and there's very much an AC Milan in there. Go into the ground, it's in the middle of nowhere. You're looking at the team, and just the thought of being in a European Cup final was almost enough. That's how big it felt, because we hadn't been there for so long. You go in there and you go 1-0 down after 50 seconds. I know what them Spurs fans felt the other day. It was low. And we fought back and we did well. It's forgotten now how well we did in the first half. We probably should have had a penalty. We go 2-0 down, then we go 3-0 down. And a moment that'll live with me for the rest of my days was you'll never walk alone at half time when the players were coming back out onto the pitch. And at first, when he first started singing, and I'll admit, I said, for fuck's sake, it's not the answer to everything, you know, because I was so upset. But then it just took over me. It was visceral. It was unbelievable. The players come out second half, and to go from 3-0 down to 3-3 against the best team in Europe without a shadow of a doubt, a European giant with the best players, was amazing. But then the moments that I knew, you said even the penalty shootout, we were in favourites. I think we were by then, because the moment that Shevchenko takes that double shot, and Jerzy Dudek makes the save, forget about it. Andy Gray says it on the commentary, you might just start writing our name on the cup now, because it's our time. Then to go and win a European Cup final on penalties, it doesn't get any more dramatic than that. Now listen, stress, that's probably why I'm bald, you know what I mean? Liverpool have put me through that stress over the years. But to win a European Cup final, the first one for 20 years, I've not seen us playing one. You've seen us, that's our third in Madrid that you've seen. It's the third that I've been to. Fourth, So, because it was the first one, it's unbelievable. And then for the celebrations after it, the celebrations in Madrid were unreal. They'll go to my grave with me. The celebrations in Istanbul, they're iconic. Them Steven Gerrard holding on to the fellas in the crowd, and they're crying. Players coming across with the European Cup, and you can see on their faces they can't believe it. It's unbelievable. And then to come back from that, the parade. Listen, the parade the other day was special. 750,000 people in Liverpool. And it's not this team's fault that the parade was sent the wrong way, but it was. The parade in 2005 finished up on St George's Plaza, and I understand why they won't do it again, because that's a ridiculous amount of people to have in such a small space. But that was special in and of itself, because it was, the bus was trapped in, and everyone was there together, and it's all enclosed. It wasn't just a big line of people waiting for it to go. It was a celebration, a city, a club, a fan base, and a city all together as one for an hour and a half. Unbelievable.
What more can you say on that one? I think two solid debates. I couldn't choose them. There's one of the greatest games of football of all time, and one like Dan, which is very special to me. I'm sure you guys will offer your feedback. That's been another Versus, and we'll be back with them again soon.